Come on, y'all, praise the Lord.
Blessings come down, every chain is broken, and you
We are the people of the moment. Satan. I declare, I'm telling you, you are blessed on the end. You are blessed coming out. I'm not just saying something, I'm telling the word of God. You are the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath.
Press that guest icon and we will respond to you in a personal way. But we thank you you for joining us on this morning. God bless you. Let's give our first time to Israel. Wow, that ticket sales are really going fast, and we are so appreciative of everyone that who has already purchased their tickets for our all-white party. Everybody, you can make your purchases here before service and or after service. Let me tell you, there is no party unless it's Lee Pastor Leroy. I'm telling you, we need to have a good time.
A little bit more practice, baby.
Now, he got to like
a bottle.
But anyway, it's all
great. Practice, y'all, practice. If I'm not coming to the party, you don't have to ask for practice.
So ticket sales are only
55. I slow dance on.
Amen. That's all right, Pastor. Just stay with me.
Good time. Yeah.
All right, we got each other. But the tickets are only $75. If you want to be a part of that, I'm telling you, we're gonna have an awesome time. Good food, fellowship, fun, and good music and dance. We also got something else special that's cooking that's going to be awesome that you need to come and be a part of. Listen, the pandemic's been taking place for many of us, but we are out, we in church, have a great time, but we're going to have a good time on that evening as well. So we want every Relentless Global Church member, not only members, y'all can bring y'all family and friends too, okay? And you don't have to be married. You don't have to be married. If you're single and you want to come and have a good time, please come.
Bring your date with you.
Bring your date with you. And if you don't have a date, just come on. I know some people that's bought two tickets already that don't have a date. They say, do you have to have a date? No, you don't have to. We just want to have good fellowship.
Good, fun, and fellowship. Amen.
Amen. We want to say happy birthday to Taylor and Terry. Yeah.
Let's stand to our feet. Let's pray. Y'all ready for the word?
Yeah.
All right. Hold hands with those you. come in with. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this time of study of your word. Father, we're open. Fill us with your spirit. Lord, we ask you to open the eyes of our understanding. We desire to want to know you. We desire your love, your peace, your grace, your anointing, your favor to be upon us. And Father, this is one thing we vow. We will never take you for granted. We give you the glory and the honor that's due your name. So on today, allow not my words to fall to the ground, but allow your words to be a seed sown into the hearts of we, your believers. And it shall produce. It shall produce the kingdom results that we desire. We love you, Lord, and we give you the honor and the praise and the thanks for everything that's said and done. In Jesus' name. Can I receive?
I receive.
Amen. You may be seated. God bless you all. Good morning, Facebook Live. And we dismiss the children. Children, we may go to Children's Church. God bless you all. We bless the children. Go have fun. Obey your teachers. And learn something. My wife likes to say that when we're walking in the neighborhood, there's some kids always at the bus corner early in the morning. She'll say to them, learn something. And I'm going to say, why are you messing with these kids? The sun has risen. Learn something. Learn something. All right. We're teaching a new series of lessons. I hope you all have enjoyed the series that we've been talking about, faith, because faith is the only thing that pleases God. So since faith is the only thing that pleases God, it will behoove us to learn about our faith, to increase our faith, to get closer to God, because faith comes by
hearing,
and hearing by. So I must continually, go after God to increase my faith, because your God is the same yesterday. What God did for Moses, God can do for you today.
Amen.
He's the same yesterday.
Yes.
He's the same today. And he's the same in my future.
Yes.
Amen. So we've been talking about on Wednesday about overcoming the fear of the unknown. Knowing that God is in my tomorrow and my future is what? Secure, right? So now, if you turn your Bibles to Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1, the title of this new series is entitled, Focus on the Finish Line. To be focused. Focus on the finish line. Focus means to concentrate. It means to centralize. It means the center of attention. Watch this one. It means clear vision.
Amen.
Focus.
Amen.
It means clear vision. It means attraction.
Yes.
So our new lesson series is entitled Focus on the Finish Line. The Lord gave us a word at the beginning of this year, and he already gave me the word for next year as well.
Praise God.
But the word for this year, and watch this, especially once we get our building, y'all are going to see a big sign that's going to always be declared over Relentless Global Church.
Yes, sir.
The word is going to be what the Lord gave us at the beginning of the foundation of this ministry.
Yes.
This is the year of the kingdom.
Yes,
yes, sir.
Amen. It's going to be by the kingdom of God.
Yes.
There are no more limits to what? Your life.
Yes.
So what are you saying? You can do anything.
Yes, sir. Yes.
If you can believe, all things are possible. So, for you to have what you believe, all you got to do is increase your faith.
Yes,
yes, sir.
Amen.
Because Jabez told God, expand my borders.
Yes.
He wanted more.
Yes.
I said he wanted more.
Amen.
He wanted more for the right reasons, to give God glory.
Yes.
So now, if we're going to focus on what God, let me finish my phrase. There are no more limits, no more stress. No more strain, no more struggle, no more toil, no more fear. There's five of those. You will forever, throughout this ministry, see those five written somewhere in Religious Global Church.
Amen.
Because those five equal the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Think about it. How far can you go with no stress? Think about it. No strain. Everything you pray for comes to pass.
Amen.
With no strain. No struggle.
Yes.
How far would you be in life with no struggle?
My God.
How about this one? How far can you go in life with no toil?
Amen.
Toil is hard work. Because toil is under the curse. And Jesus came to redeem us from the curse of the law. So there's no more toil. If you can hear this and receive it, your stressful days are gone. No stress, no strain, no struggle, no toil. And I'm teaching on this one on Wednesdays. And you have to follow it. And again, I want to share this with you again. Help us share the messages.
Yes.
Every member of this church, y'all need to help us on Facebook Live and make comments to encourage and put the information out. I'm not trying to build a church. I'm trying to build the kingdom.
Yeah.
Y'all hear that?
Yeah.
So the last one is no more fear. Listen. Imagine. What would life be where there is zero fear?
Yeah.
That you make up in your mind. I'm not even talking about God told you to do it. You make up in your mind, I want to be married. And it comes to pass.
Amen.
Because there's no fear.
Because
you have bad relationships. You make bad decisions in men. You make bad decisions in women. And I understand that, right? It happens to all of us.
Yeah.
But if you take away out, there is no fear, I can be the president of the company and I don't have to be an employee.
That's
right. Amen.
Because I'm not afraid to step out on faith and believe God for my own dreams. No fear. Everybody shout no fear.
No fear.
Now, if I'm going to focus this year, we wrote down, many of you wrote down your vision for the year. And we're going to do it next year too. Because y'all think we're going to stop out? Y'all think December 31st is going to be the end? Why would that be the end when you got January 1st? I'm still going to believe God.
Amen.
You don't stop believing God.
Amen.
When you stop believing God, you in heaven.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Can I say it again? When we stop believing God, we're with him.
Yes.
Yes.
So the number, I tell them I'm preaching right now, I call them back. You wrote your vision out. You sowed your seed.
Yes.
And you put it in the hands of your prophets, your men and women of God.
Yes.
We anointed them.
Yes.
We covered them.
Yes.
We prayed for them.
Yes.
I said, and it shall.
Yes, ma'am.
Ain't no doubt.
Yes, sir.
It shall.
Yes, sir.
Come to pass.
Yes.
Because there's no more stress, strain, struggle, toil, or fear. I'm literally walking on my water. I'm literally receiving my dream come to pass. That's why we got to meditate. We got to visit our future. I know December 31st is not here yet, but I'm walking into December 31st by faith.
Amen. Amen.
And watch this. And I have. I'm in my future by meditation.
Amen.
Everything. I'm a business owner and I'm a multi-millionaire. I have 25 employees. They love this company. We are so prosperous. I sow into their lives. I sow into my employees 1 car a year because I see myself being blessed to be a blessing.
Yeah.
But I'm meditating on it. And then I come out of December 31st and I come back into my presence.
Come on.
Yeah. And then when I come out of meditation, I'm in my presence. I look back at my presence and say, I'll be there. I'll see you in a little bit.
Yeah.
That's what meditation is all about.
Yeah.
You got to see your son and your daughter doing well. Put the best picture of your son. The best picture of your daughter and say, they are men of God. That's my prophet.
Yeah.
I don't care if they're in jail. I don't care if they I don't care if they're gay. I don't care where they are. I have whatsoever I say. And you can't be afraid. You can't be ashamed to go towards the finish line of your faith and say, I have. I have. I'm going to be better off this time next year.
Yes.
And you will see.
All right.
You will see.
Yes.
Because you got to declare with boldness what you're a desiring God of. And you got to let somebody hear it.
Yes.
And then when they see it, they'll say, they said that.
Yeah.
He said that. He said you're going to have this kind of car. A man broke, he drive. They said their child was in jail. And then the pulpit prophesying.
Come on.
Because I believe God for my children too.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
My grandmother went to be with the Lord this year. My dad, my aunt, my mother went to be with the Lord. We just buried her this past weekend. My wife's first cousin was buried this weekend. There are saints of God who have come before us, and they died in faith.
All right.
Not only do I have those things, I got the ones in the Bible, like Abel. Because you got to go to Hebrews chapter 11 to read it before you come to chapter 12, and it says, therefore. So you can't read therefore without reading the previous chapter. It was talking about great men and women of God who have died in their faith. They believe God.
Amen.
Abel believed God. What was he believing God? He gave a better offering.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Enoch believed God. What was his focus on? His love for God.
Amen.
Can you imagine? You love God so much that God says, I'm jealous. I don't want you with them. I want you with me. And he was not. They looked around. Where's Enoch? Man, God took him. God straight up snatched him. What kind of life do you live? To where God loves you that much, he wants you home with him. They didn't have no burial, no funeral, none of that. God just took him. And watch this. How can it happen and the family be satisfied? Because you don't read nowhere where the family was made.
Amen.
Because he had obviously talked about his relationship with God. Oh, I love you so much. I can't wait to see you. I can't wait to be with you, Lord. You are my heart. You are my dream. You are my goal. Ooh, y'all not hearing me.
Yeah.
You are the source of my strength.
Yeah.
And he loved God. So much that God said, come on home, baby. I want you with me.
Yes.
Then you got to know, what was his focus? His obedience.
Yes.
God told this man to build a ship, a cruise ship, an ark, when there was no rain.
All right.
If there was never any sight of rain, but God says build a ship, why do we need a ship? There's no rain.
Wow.
We're on dry land. There's no ocean nowhere near us.
Right.
You know how big that is?
That is.
That you're in the desert land.
Wow.
And God says build.
Wow.
Yep.
And he obeyed.
Yes.
And because of his obedience, his entire family was saved because one man obeyed God.
Amen.
How many people will be affected, connected to your life if you just obey?
Amen.
Amen. We're talking about focus on the finish line. What was Abraham? His focus was on his faith. His focus was, God said, I'm going to have a child, but I don't have it.
Yeah.
But I'm acting like I have. Focus for his life was, I believe God. Was he challenged? Yes. Was it difficult? Yes. Was he challenged in his marriage? Yes. Was he challenged with his family? Yes. But he held on to what God said.
Yes.
You shall have a son.
Yes.
And it came to pass. And then there's Jacob. What was he focused on? The blessing. This man was so blessed, man. This is incredible. This man's life, he went through so many difficult challenges. And there are men in here under the sound of my voice. There are women in here right now under the sound of my voice. You've been through so much. You've been through so much as a child. You've been through so much as a teenager. People just don't understand you. You've been through so much as an adult. Relationships not working. You're struggling about that. You've been through so much. But hold on to your faith. He's still at 35, I ain't here yet. At midnight, God shows up and pours a blessing on your life like Jacob. Pours a blessing on your life. Everybody don't see it. And what's it? They're going to call you. Don't you stop believing, God. Stay focused on your dream. Stay focused on your goal. Don't you stop confessing the word. Don't you stop praying. Don't you stop seeking the Lord.
Yes.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
And so he says here, a cloud of witnesses. And then he says, okay, saints, listen up. Now, if you're going to see the end of your faith, you got to deal with your sins.
Mm-hmm.
Because he says, you're surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, but let us, let you, notice, not God and not demons.
Mm-hmm.
Let us lay aside every weight. with at least one. Some of us in the hood, we got two, three. You know what I'm saying? We got to be mature enough to be honest and real. Some of us are struggling with fears. Yeah. Right. Some of us cannot let go of that. He hurt me. He betrayed me. He lied to me. Okay, that was 10 years ago. Let's go. We cannot spend our lives being angry and bitter about life. Yeah. Because a lot of our situations, we chose it. Uh-huh. A lot of our hurts and pains because you chose that. And we got to accept the responsibility. So as soon as I accept the responsibility for my life, then this is what I need to do. I need to get rid of my sins. Everybody say, why?
Why?
Everybody say, why, Pastor?
Why, Pastor?
Because your sins trap you. It snares. That word ensnares us or traps. Wow. Watch this. You trap yourself. Yeah. And we can name all kinds of stuff, but I'm not here to point out different sins. That's not my point. My point is this. You got to say to yourself, stop. Everybody stop, stop.
Stop.
Now, I don't need the oil. Yeah. I don't need the protein to do it.
Right.
I don't need to call and say, pray, pray now, pray. For you to stop smoking, stop buying cigarettes. For you to stop getting pregnant out of wedlock, stop sleeping around. For you to stop getting all these tickets to where you lost your insurance, you jacked up, stop running the stop sign. Oh, I lost the way. See, we want God to move. We want a miracle. No, stop. Just stop. You know what you're doing, so just stop. I'm not here to bring conviction. I'm just trying to get you to understand that there is in Christ no condemnation. So there's nothing new under the sun. We all struggle with things. But you have to be straight up with yourself and say, I need to stop being an angry black man, white man, Hispanic. I need to stop being angry.
Yeah.
So how do I get rid of my anger? Fall in love with Jesus. Yeah. He'll exchange your anger for his love.
Yeah. Amen. Yeah.
Amen.
Because you're trapping yourself.
Yeah.
You wrote your vision down.
Yeah.
You sold your seed.
Yeah.
You put it in our hands. And we believe between now and December 31st. Why would you go through all of that and you still stay stuck in your seat?
Amen.
We need to make a decision to stop.
Yes.
Many of us deal with bad attitudes and all these other things. Hey, listen, we all deal with it. We all deal with it.
Yes.
But you have to be mature enough to say to yourself, I got to stop being angry.
Yes.
I got to let that bomb go. Shaniqua, I forgive. See, on our end, we get the phone call. That's why I'm saying certain things. People are really struggling. That's why the one thing I'm here to tell you. The one thing that happened with the pandemic, I still say it's from the pyramid. But it exposed so many weaknesses in the church.
Right.
People didn't believe God if they thought they needed.
Yeah. Yes.
People didn't have strong faith if they thought they would.
Yes.
Man, I'm telling you, at the height of the pandemic, alcohol went up,
right.
Drug use went up,
yep.
Adultery went up,
yep.
Abuse, physical abuse, male, brother and sister, they going at it. All that went up. You couldn't find counselors. You could not find counselors for 3-4 weeks. You could not. You had the cash in hand to pay for them. They wasn't that they didn't want your money. They just didn't have time. They were booked.
Because
people are crying for help because they all in the house together and realize, I really don't like you.
Yeah.
And people have come to the conclusion, I didn't know you talk like that. When I sit down with people to counsel, you will be amazed at the things that they're mad about.
Yep.
Angry. And that's a snare.
Yes.
See, y'all want to hear the sin I'm talking about? Adultery. Oh my God. How can he do it? Oh, she had a good man. Why? See, that ain't the only sin. Your bad attitude is a sin. Your bad, nasty attitude is a big time sin.
Yes.
You need to correct your attitude.
Yes.
All right?
Amen.
Walk with a try, smile. Try. set before us. That means your vision that you wrote down. We got to work on ourselves so we can figure out what it is God would have us do. Now watch this. Focus on your faith. And focus on the finish line means increase your faith. Number one, write this down. Number one is increase your faith. How does faith come? By hearing and hearing by the word. So put Pastor Ben and Pastor Leroy on and listen to them every day. Because we're your pastors. And I'm not saying you can't listen to somebody else. But you also need to listen to your pastor before
Amen.
You listen to everybody else. Right? All right?
Amen.
It ain't no ego trip. I'm just saying, my sheep know my voice.
Amen.
Y'all understand that?
Amen.
So that's not an ego. Okay? Increase this hearing the word of God by faith comes by hearing and hearing my word. So listen to your pastors, preach the word. Go on Facebook Live and listen to it over and over again.
Mm-hmm.
Open up your Bible and read the word. You don't have to understand everything. But I told a young man, I was talking to somebody today, and I said, when my mother set me down at the table, and I did my homework first when I was a little kid, and then I did my, then she made me read the Psalms every single day, and then my tongue loose. I used to stammering tongue. Then one day, a miracle happened, my tongue loose. But what I did not know was God was working on my future because he knew he was going to call me to do this. And the word, as I was, you don't have to know everything. Just read it. And you will find out the word is coming in you, over time. So read the word. And then you all of a sudden, you'll be talking to people and things start coming out of you because you don't realize the word is a seed somewhere in your heart. And the mouth shall speak what's where? In your heart. That's why when the pressure comes on, stuff come out. I said when the pressure comes on, words come out. And we'll all know what you believe. Amen. So number one was your faith. Number two, the call of God in your life must be revealed. You must know why you're in this earth. Yeah, I'm a businessman. Yeah, I'm a truck driver. Yeah, I work for UPS, but I also have a call on my life. I'm more than just a UPS truck driver. God has a call on my life as well. Number three, visions and dreams. Focus on the finish line. Visions and dreams come to pass. Number four, your health. You got to start working on your health. You can't just believe God. Lord, heal me by the strength of Jesus, and you keep eating the pork.
Right. Amen.
You keep eating all the bad sugars. My doctor told me, Leroy, you have to stop drinking apple juice, orange juice, grape juice, all the juices that I love. And I said, why? He said, because of the sugar. Yeah. You're too close to diabetes.
Right.
So he says, you got to stop drinking so much of this. He didn't say zero. He just said, drink more what?
Water.
And I'm like, water. But guess what I have to do? I have to go to Sam's and pack up cases of water so I can live long and strong. But if I don't do that, then sickness comes. And now I'm believing God for a miracle. Why would we have to put ourselves to believe in God for a miracle when the blessing is already on your life?
Amen.
Christians are not to live their lives for a miracle every day. Christians just simply ought to believe in the blessing. In the blessing, I have everything.
Amen.
Everything's in the blessing.
That's right.
Wealth is a part of the focus we're believing for the end of the year as well. So don't act like you don't need money. Don't act like you don't desire it. Because all of us go to work for money.
Amen.
So it's not something new. It's just the idea. You just have to do it under the kingdom of God umbrella. So when God does it and supernaturally blesses you, he told Peter to go out there and fish, cast your net on the right side. Until Jesus said the words, the fish was ignoring their net.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
See, amen. I got one brother down.
Amen.
Watch this. Until you declare the word,
yes,
the fish can't find
right.
you.
Amen.
So
amen.
When you declare the word, cast your net on the right side, then the fish all of a sudden heard the voice of Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus created the fish. The fish knew his voice.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Because the Creator spoke.
Yes.
Cast your net on the right side. They cast their net on the right side. They had so much fish that the boat began to sink. Then they had to pull the fish to the shore, and they had to separate the good from the bad. All of a sudden, they got a millionaire business overnight.
Amen.
Because somebody there declared.
Amen.
And in this world,
come on,
yes,
they're waiting to hear the sons of God
yes.
declare and decree. I'm blessed.
Yes. Amen.
Going in and coming out.
Amen. Amen.
Your children, number six, your children, your family, your marriage, declare and decree over your family. I'm saying stay focused. I'm saying don't give up on your dreams. I'm saying the last one is rebuilding your trust and confidence in God. Come back to church so we can preach to you. Listen to the word so you can be preached to. Read the word so you can study it. You got to go after this. Because why let me preach to you for a whole year on the word that the Lord has given us and you do nothing to change?
Amen. Amen.
You still cursing the wife out? Really? You've been coming to church, you've been giving your tithes, you've been giving your offerings, you've been faithful in coming to church, you changed your life about the things of God, and you never change. Why would you do that? Why would you not want better?
Right. Yes. Amen.
Even if you slip up and curse your wife out, the next thing you should be saying, baby, I'm sorry. Yep. I'm working on myself. Baby, please forgive me. I'm trying to change. And a wise wife said, baby, it's okay. I'm praying for you. Let's forgive you.
Come on.
We got to leave. Because next year this time, we're going to be a whole other level.
Right. Amen.
Now we're not cursing each other. We just irritating each other. You don't have to agree.
Yeah. Come on.
Hey, I don't care what y'all say. That's an upgrade.
Yeah.
Then the year after that, now we're not irritating each other. Now we can just see each other and know exactly what we see.
Right.
From level of faith to another level of faith to another level of faith.
Wow.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, listen to this. 1 Peter 1 and 9. We're talking about focus on the finish line. I'm going to see the end of my faith. 1 Peter 1 and 9. Clearly it says, receiving the end of your faith. So there's something you're believing God for. The word is saying right there, watch this saying, you can have it.
Amen.
See how everybody, oh, y'all, I know y'all right. Everybody look at the pastor. Quick second. Everybody look at me. Let me see your eyes. For him to say that, you are definitely believing God for something.
Amen.
What
Amen.
He's saying to you is, you can have it.
Amen.
Hmm.
That's good.
You can have the peace. You can have the love. You can have the wealth. You can have the business. You can have everything. You can have the house. You can have the car. The only issue is when you're talking about your faith, faith is a walk of love. Faith working by love. Yes. But faith is also what you do to please God. So watch this. If you don't walk in love with what you're doing, and if you don't love God and put him first, none of this comes to pass.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you can have it. Watch this. You can get married without God. You can start a business without God.
Amen.
You can't, you can buy a house and car without God.
Amen.
But the blessing of the Lord makes rich.
Yeah.
Come on now, y'all know it.
Amen.
So the difference is the blessing that comes from God makes rich and has no sorrow. I can enjoy it.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
Isaiah 40 and 29. Watch this. Man of God, can you give me Proverbs 24 and 10? And we're going to go back to Isaiah 40 and 29. Give me Proverbs 24 and 10 first. And we're going to switch it. Proverbs 24 and 10.
Amen.
If you, notice, not God and not devil. If you faint, fall, fail, or quit in the day of adversity, the word adversity is pressure.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know where you stand when the pressure comes out.
Yeah.
Pressure. Troubles come. We don't know where you stand. Yeah. Distress comes. The pandemic, right? Mm-hmm. Watch this. In the day of challenge, if you fail or fall, your strength clearly is your responsibility.
Right.
Clearly. Clearly. And one of the things I'm going to preach to you is to get you to understand, until you accept the responsibility for your life and stop blaming your past, stop blaming the ex, stop blaming your mother, stop blaming your father, I don't care what they did to you, you are at a place where you are an adult now, you have to make decisions for you.
Amen. Amen.
No, everybody shout, no excuses.
No excuses.
So watch this. Your strength is small. So how am I going to increase my strength? Increase my faith. How do I increase my faith? Increase my word intake.
Yes. Yes.
Now turn to Isaiah 40 and 29. Now watch this. He's talking about your strength. Watch what Isaiah says, 40 and 29.
Yes, sir.
Isaiah says, he gives what?
Power.
He gives power to the one. We. That comes a place in all of our lives where we're not on our A game.
Yes.
That comes a place in our lives where we're all weak. All of us are subject to it. Jesus failed me.
Amen.
And had to pray, Father, forgive me. If you can let this cup pass from me, look, if we can do it another way, I'm struggling right now. What happened? Angels came and did what? Gave him power or gave him what? Strength. We all come to the place of weakness.
Yes.
And to those who have no might, he increases strength.
He increases.
The reason why he's going to do that is because he judges your heart. He knows that you love him. He knows that you're not in a place of strength, but he also knows that your heart is for him.
Yes.
So what does he do? He puts his super on your natural and calls the supernatural to happen.
Yes.
That's when you can see a miracle.
Amen.
When you're at your weakest,
yes,
he increases strength. When my mother passed, I shared not one kid.
Yeah.
I realized I was at such a place of peace.
Wow.
Watch this. That the scripture came to my sister and oh, yeah, I forgot to tell y'all, on behalf of my sister, I thank you for your love, your prayers, your support, financially, and all those great things. Relentless Local Church is a place where love reigns, and as your pastor, I receive your love, man. Thank y'all for
that.
I mean, I appreciate your love, the heart, the knowledge. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yeah.
But without that, right here. Now, I can tell you a minute, but I'm anointed now, so I got to say it a different way. So my voice shifts under the anointing. So forgive me, I just had a long telling you the truth.
Mm-hmm.
But without that, I got to go.
Amen. Amen.
Because I experienced a peace that came over me, and I'm telling you, it truly surpassed understanding. Why am I not praying?
All right.
Why am I not hurt? Why am I not grieving? Why? I was playing with my wife around the house. My wife kept looking at me like, wow, really, you are? Then I was jumping in the plant. I said, babe, I need a hug. I'm breathing. I'm breathing. So at the house, we were laughing. Because my mom is with the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
We don't mourn as if there's no hope, as if we don't believe in our God. Paul said, it's better for me if I go. But because of y'all need me, I'm going to stay just a little while longer.
Amen.
And he laid his hand there and gave his life because he was not afraid to die. He had finished his course.
Yeah.
Yeah. He knew it was the time of his departure.
Yeah.
My mother knew she was ready to go. She started saying, "Hey, I'm so proud of you. Fulfill your call, son. I'm so proud of you and your sister. Y'all done well. Y'all have made me so proud."
Yeah.
And I'm saying, God, where you going? Where you going?
Because
we started having a conversation. Okay, now you know everything's in place. And I'm sitting there saying, whoa, why are we having this conversation?
Yeah.
And 2 weeks later, she was with the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Because I don't care what you say, since when you're in the Lord, you know.
Yeah. Amen.
And don't nobody stop you. Because that's something personal between you and your God. Lord, I'm ready.
Right.
Amen. Glory to God.
Right.
But he gives strength.
Wow.
If you're at a place of weakness,
pray.
And believe you receive strength that only comes from him. Ecclesiastes 10 and 10. Watch this illustration of focus. Because we're talking about focus on the finish line. We're believing God by between now and the end of the year. The things that you wrote down, the things that you put in our hands, the things that you dream of, even for you at home, for those of you that are at home, you believe in God for something. Why not believe God for supernatural? Why not believe God for everything? Why not?
Yes. Amen.
I don't have nothing to lose now. I have everything to gain.
Amen.
Watch what Solomon said. If the axe head is dull and one does not sharpen the edge, watch this. Dull means dim, it means faint, vague. You know, not important, babe. Mm-hmm. It means unready.
Mm-hmm.
You should be sharp, but you're not.
Wow.
But you should be.
Uh-huh.
You got a knife at the store. You don't buy a gold knife.
Amen. Amen.
If you expect it to be sharp,
yes.
Watch this. It means sluggish, spiritless. You know you ought to be praying. You spiritless. You wonder why you don't have no strength. You spiritless. There's nothing on the inside of you. You know you ought to be reading the word, but you don't. You're spiritless. So now you don't have no strength to deal with the challenges of life. It means depressing.
Wow.
Watch this. It means slow of understanding. But then watch this, saints. You are the axe.
You are.
Mm-hmm.
We are.
You are the axe.
Yes, we are.
Watch this. In the hand of the Lord.
Yes.
And the Lord so you can go out and do great exploits. But if your edge is dull, prayerlessness.
Wow, just like that.
If your attitude is dull, you don't fast, you don't pray, you don't listen to the word. So you in the hands of the Lord are almost useless. What do you do with an attitude that is not sharp? If you don't sharpen it, you discard it.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Why? Because it's caused me more work. You become a burden to me. Because you refuse to sharpen your skills. You refuse to go to another level in your faith. You just flat out refuse. You got a bad marriage. You know you got a bad marriage. Okay, this is marriage. You got a bad marriage. You know you got to get bad marriage. But you don't go get counsel.
Wow.
You don't go to a marriage class. There are all kinds of marriage classes around the city. But you refuse to go. Oh, it costs $100. It's costing you more, brother. In a bad marriage, it's costing you more. So pay the $100 for a conference and go. Because faith comes by hearing. When I had a horrible marriage, my wife was pregnant. We were separated. We filed for divorce. I went to my banker. I was at a bank at a teller machine. Not a teller machine. At a teller booth. And I was getting some money. And then my friend, what was that girl's name? Can't remember his name. It's been years ago. She said, Lee, what's wrong? Because I'm an upbeat, happy guy. She said, what's wrong? I said, you know, I don't even know why I even told her. I said, I'm separated, just going through some things. She said, come to my church. They got marital counseling. Uh-huh. Lakewood Church. Uh-huh. And I went to Lakewood Church. Don't even know why I went. Uh-huh. But I went. Uh-huh. Then I went down for 9 months. Because uh-huh. we were separated the whole time until the baby was born. And then and my baby is Rochelle. She's my queen. She was just like a dad. She was mad at me, my baby. Mad.
Hey.
Dog.
Watch this. See, you don't have to understand everything. You just watch this thing. You just have to make some kind of effort to go for the word.
That's right.
You have to make an effort to go to the word. I went to Lakewood Church, the old Lakewood Church. Daddy O's thing was still alive back then. And I went for 9 months. Going every Tuesday. And then I realized real quick, every race was there. Every color was there. Tall, short, old, weight, thin, we were all there with the same problem. Bikers muscle in. You know, muscle up. His marriage wasn't working. I'm a skinny, young black guy. I was wrong with this. Skinny. My marriage don't work. You got the Chinese guy, short Chinese guy. His marriage didn't work. I don't mean any harm. You got the businessman with the executive suit and tie. Repaint. His marriage didn't work. We were all there with the same problem. Hugging each other, encouraging each other. And then one day, everybody shot one day.
One day.
Then one day, I was walking out the door. Minding my own business. I never met Dodie Osteen and Dan Osteen. John Osteen, never met. And that was my first time. I only met him once. And the first time I saw him, I was overwhelmed because they were so short. I mean, they were really, really tiny people.
Yeah.
And that man came to me and prophesied over me.
Yeah.
I didn't look for it. I wasn't even expecting it. But that man prophesied into my future.
Yes.
See, you can't tell me what God will do.
Yeah.
When you make a faith step towards obeying God.
Yes.
I was filing for divorce. I was separated.
Yes,
there was no reason for nothing to work.
Right.
Family didn't know a lot. Church was against us. There was a lot of craziness going on.
Yep.
But somebody made a faith step.
Yeah.
And it's all it takes. That man prophesied over me into my future.
Yeah.
That man, and even when he said it, I didn't believe.
God.
But the words were real.
Yes.
You just have to believe the word. That man said God was going to restore our man. I can go deeper than that. Y'all ready for this?
No.
I was at my Baptist traditional church after this prophecy. And I was leaving church. And a friend of mine's mother, or grandmother, lived down the street from my old church. And she was one of them old warriors, old faithful.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know she was a prophet, though. So I walk in with my friend, And she said, without introducing me to the grandmother and all that. So, you know, just talking. And she says, where's your wife? Not separated. I'm like, where that come from? And I didn't even ask her. I didn't know what to say. And she says, and my daughter Michelle was born. And she says, how's your daughter? I was in shock. I was in complete shock. And she says, thus saith the Lord.
All right.
Your marriage will be restored. You and your wife, your wife and your daughter are in a fight. And I see them in a pit, and you have to go back and bring them out. That's what she said. And she says, and when you bring them out, the day will come that you will know that the Lord spoke this word to you and it has come to pass. But what when she said that, what I did not know is a month later, she was in a fire. She, her and her brother, she and her brother that lived with her. The brother died in the fire. It was on the news. She was burned 50% of her body. And when she was, they were getting ready to unplug her, they called and said, maybe you ought to go and see her. They're about to unplug her. So I went to go see her. And she was like, see how the Holy Ghost works?
Yes.
I went to the hospital to go see her. And she lied in a coma.
Amen.
So I didn't expect them to say anything. And that God is my witness. I have no reason to lie.
Yes,
I have no reason to lie. I'm telling you what God will do for you if your heart is for Him. Everything can be a house or a car.
Yeah.
All right.
You got to connect your dreams to His purpose for your life.
Yeah. Yes. Amen.
I went to this woman's bedroom, hospital room. Oh, Ellen is 16. And I go in the room and I just sat with her for a little bit. And I'm just spending about 5-10 minutes. And I was going to leave just so he could say my personal goodbye. She starts coughing.
In a coma.
Mm-hmm. And she says, my wife preached. And she says, watch this. She says, baby, give me some water. Now I'm tripping. Now she's coughing. I'm like, and I'm looking around. What is going on? And so I get the water. And I'm shaking. And I'm pouring the water. And I get the water. She says, set me up. No, they got the bed. She pushed her money to sit down. So she raised up. She drank the water. And she says, this is the rest of the prophet.
Wow. Amen. Wow.
Because nobody knows your struggles. Because we don't tell everything.
Amen.
Nobody knows your pain. Because we don't tell everything.
Amen.
She said that God was going to call us into ministry. And that was so far away from us. That was so far away. She said, God's going to call you to ministry. God's going to restore your family. And she says, and this shall come to pass. The next day she died.
Amen.
The first night, my wife and I, after we got back together, God restored her. The first night we slept in the bed together, after we were separated for 9 months, I get a phone call, she died. Because this is more. Listen to me. It's more. You can have your house. You can have your car. You can have your dreams. But I'm here to tell you, God is calling you to a higher call.
Amen. Amen.
That's why you got to forgive.
Yes.
That's why you got to keep your heart pure. That's why you got to keep your hands clean. Don't look at yourself. And don't you ever, after the day, say any negative words out of your mouth about yourself, about your God, about your family, about your church. Never, never, never say any more negative words about your life.
Amen.
Because you are the prophet of your life.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And what you say literally can come to pass.
Amen.
Amen.
So forgive the past so God can give you your dream.
Amen.
That's it.
Do not allow your axe head to be dull. Sharpen your skill set.
Yes.
I hope you know I'm not talking about your business right now.
Amen.
I'm talking about your relationship
Amen.
With God.
Yes.
Sharpen your skills. Set a time every day you pray.
Yes.
Set a place. Anoint your place in your house or your apartment and say, at this chair, every day, this is where I meet God. At this chair, on my knees, and let the tears flow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And let God meet you at the place and the point I'm broke financially. I'm broke in my relationship. Nothing is working in my life. But if I touch the hem of your garment, I shall be made whole. And my brother and my sister, it is time for you to be made whole. Sharpen your axe. You are in the hand of the Lord. It's time for you to let it go. It's time for you to move forward.
Amen.
It's time for you to talk to yourself and look in the mirror and tell yourself you're blessed.
Amen.
Look in the mirror and tell yourself you are anointed.
Amen.
Look in the mirror and call yourself a prophet. Look in the mirror and call yourself beautiful. Call yourself handsome. Call yourself blessed.
Yes.
Because I have what I say about my life. It really don't matter what they say.
Amen.
It only
Amen.
Matters what I say based on my faith.
Yes.
He says, and does not sharpen his axe at an edge, then he must use more strength. More strength. You out there on your own with no strength. You're tired because your axe is dull. You keep hitting against wood that won't split because you're not sharp. And he says, but wisdom. Here we go. But wisdom. Where does wisdom come from? The Lord. If anyone lacks wisdom, Jay said, let him ask of who? The Lord, who gives what? Liberally to all those who what? Believe. So if you lack wisdom, you lack grace, you lack anointing, you need to pray. Because asking is a petition. In prayer. Sharpen your skill set and he'll give you what? Wisdom. And what will the wisdom do? Bring you into
Amen.
What's success? I'm free from drugs. I'm free from alcoholism. I'm free from depression. I'm free from migraine headaches. I'm free from all the devils and the demons in the world. Can't let it stop me. I'm here to tell you, my brother, my sister, that don't live for you. You just have to be hungry and thirsty for this. Sharpen your skill set. Stop complaining. Do you realize that everybody you cry and whine and complain to do absolutely nothing to help you?
Amen.
Because nobody wants to hear a whiner and a complainer constantly. Last week you was crying about this. This week you was crying about it. Next week you crying about it. After all, nobody want to hear no more of your crying. Nobody want to hear all that. Sooner or later, you got to increase your faith. You got to sharpen your skill set. You got to get yourself into your prayer room. You got to open up your Bible without me telling you to. Open up your Bible. Start with Psalms 1. And read. And then go to Psalms 2 next day. They say Psalms 3. And you're going to keep putting the word in you. Keep putting the word in you. Keep putting the word into you. And there'll come a day the Lord will give you that word. There'll come a day the Lord will restore your marriage. There'll come a day that boom, you meet the right partner, and all of a sudden you're made. There's nothing impossible.
Amen.
I'm telling you nothing.
Amen.
Absolutely nothing. And when I came to this revelation, look, everybody in my past, I forgave.
Yeah.
This isn't
working. Yes. Amen.
It's that word mean that my dream and my future goes for you.
Amen.
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 So from here on out, take those confessions, read them every day.
Yes,
pray every day. Write your own personal vision, put it on a wall. Some people call it a vision board, that's fine, all right? But you got to have something on the wall that you start checking out. One, I'm believing for this. Check it out. Two, I'm believing for this. Check it out. Three, I'm believing for this. Check it out. And you, and as you check them out, you will see your faith doing this.
Come on.
Now, once my list is fulfilled, watch this. Strengthen my brother. What do you believe for? I'm going to be myself agreeing with you. What do you believe for? I'm going to set my faith with you. You believe for your God. You believe for your son. I set my faith with you. Because once you are restored, you got to care about your family. Once you are restored, strengthen your brother. Y'all get it?
Yes, sir.
Jesus is the only way to God. He is the way, the truth, and the life. The Bible says about Jesus, he died. And when he shed his blood, that blood cleanses you. He was buried and on the third day was risen. And these are Jesus' words. He says, all power in heaven and in earth is in my hand. And he's bestowed upon the church the power of the kingdom. If you're ready to have power in your life, my brother, my sister, give your life to Jesus. Our second appeal is to rededicate your life to the Lord. And maybe you're saying, Pastor, I'm already saved, but I've gotten off track. I need to rededicate my life. I need to recommit. You can do that today. Because all of us needed a second chance, a third chance, a fourth chance. Amen?
Amen.
And lastly, you can join this church. Come to a place where there's love, where love reigns. Come to a place where we preach Jesus. Come to a place where we can help you learn and we can help you grow. To increase your faith, to get into the kingdom, and let you know that there are no more limits to your life. So I'm giving three appeals. Give your life to Jesus. You dedicate your life to join the church. If that's you, by every head is bowed, every eye is closed, just lift your hand. We won't embarrass you in any way. We just want to make sure who we're praying for. We want to minister to you to make sure that every spiritual need in your life is met in Jesus' name. Is there anyone that's asking the appeals in Jesus' mighty name? Even if you're at home on Facebook Live, you can go to our website at www.relentlessglobalchurch.org. You can click on the link there and let us know that you can send your prayer request. You can let us know that you got saved or you want to get saved, and we will minister to you as well. Well, we declare every need is met. Everybody put their hands together. Yeah. Always like to give a scripture when it comes to giving. Genesis chapter 4, verse 4. And I want to thank you, Relentless Global Church, for your continued financial support. You guys have been doing a fantastic job. Let's continue to do that. And let's obey God in our giving. Let's stay strong in the area. Because, you know, people typically around the holidays start slowing down. Don't do that with God.
Amen.
With God, let's continue to keep him first. Amen. Amen. But we talked about Abel in the lesson. Abel brought the first thing of his flock. Of the fatness of his firstborn of his flock and their fat. And the Lord respected Abel's and his offering. The reason why Cain killed Abel was because of jealousy.
Amen.
And it was over giving.
Amen.
Isn't that something? You kill your brother because he outgave you? And then God respected him. What was the difference between Cain and Abel? Cain was a farmer. But what God required was a lamb. Because something had to be shed by blood. You know, blood had to be shed, while vegetable and carrots can't do that. So what Cain should have done was went to his brother and said, can I buy a lamb? Can I buy a goat? Can I buy a calf? Because I have to sacrifice to the Lord. Because the Lord, I don't care how you twist it and turn it, the Lord requires a tithe.
Amen.
The Lord, not me, because it was in your Bible before we all was born. The Lord requires tithes and offerings. And that's just the scripture. I didn't come up with the idea. But because Abel obeyed, watch today's verse. God had respect. But he did not respect Cain's offering because Cain didn't obey God. And Cain was upset about it. And his countenance fell, next verse. Watch what God says. Why? Why are you mad, man? Why are you angry? Nothing ain't working. Why are you mad? I don't have a harvest. Why are you upset? One is rising while the other one is going down. Because one obeyed God and the other one did not. He says, next verse, why has your countenance fallen? If you obey, if you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not, sin lies at the door. And a whole lot of us there's no curse that comes upon the church because Jesus Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. So you're not cursed if you don't give. Watch this. But you will experience the results of it.
Yeah. Okay.
Because there are some blessings that only come God's way. And when you obey God in your giving, don't be afraid to tithe. I know a lot of us are at a place where we're struggling with that. But I'm here to tell you, until you try it, you won't know. We had a testimony of a brother. My wife and I went to dinner with a couple members of this church. His wife tithed and he did not. And he said, Pastor, you weren't the first pastor that I could actually feel like I can trust.
Yes.
And he started tithing for the first time.
Yes.
In 3 months, Yes. His salary double.
Yes. Come on.
Because you believe what God said. And when you do it well, you'll reap the benefits. Because we got too many testimonies in this church about how people, God is blessing the people with finances and all the things, our homes and trucks. As a matter of fact, the same brother bought his wife a brand new truck for the first time in their life. They never bought a truck or a vehicle new. And I was shocked she wanted a truck, a big one. A big one, it's nice too. And he bought his wife what she desired. And they just as happy as they can be.
Yes.
Listen, when you obey God, all of us got a testimony when we didn't obey God. What
happened?
Yeah. I'm not talking about just getting it. I'm just talking about life.
Oh, yeah.
We don't obey God when it comes to sex. We don't obey God when it comes to finance. We don't obey God when it comes to relationship. We don't obey God when it comes to honoring spiritual gifts. When you obey God, I'm here to tell you, I can testify, your life can go smooth.
Amen.
It really can. And you can be happy about it.
Yes.
In your single state, you can be happy.
Yes, please.
You really can. Yes, if we're going to obey God, God can do it
exceeding.
Abundantly.
Yes.
Above all that by faith, we ask. And
faith.
Yes. Can you imagine a blessing come just like all of it?
Yes. Ooh, amen.
Brother, you know how awesome that is?
Yes,
I just thought about it and it showed up.
Yeah.
That's the blessing.
Amen.
And the blessing of the Lord that you reach. And ask the song. Are you ready to give?
Yeah.
All right, everybody got an envelope? They need an envelope? Are we ready to give? Okay, let's go ahead and sow our tithes, our offerings, our gifts of love. Come on, baby. Amen. Glory to God. We are excited about what God, watch this, is doing in your life.
Amen.
Hey, don't be slack. You go after that word hard between now and the end of the year. Lay hands on your, you know we did that anointing law? Lay hands on your husband. Lay hands on your children. Anoint your children. Anoint everything in your heart. Whatever it is. Anoint your checkbook.
Yes.
Y'all better hear what I'm saying. I'm not just saying something just be saying. I'm telling you, take that anointing oil, put it on your knee. Whatever's hanging on your body.
Yes.
Whatever's not working.
Yes.
I'm telling you, anoint your body. Anoint the things in your heart. And watch God bring it past what you're believing for.
Yes.
I believe in a supernatural God.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but I believe my God can move. All right, stand to your feet.
Anything else? Yeah. Stand to your feet. I encourage everyone to go out to the front lobby and get your tickets. They're available for $75. We want everyone to be a part of our Christmas festivities. We're going to have a good time on that evening, which is Sunday. It's going to be Friday, December 3rd. And I'm telling you, we are going to have a wonderful time, not only for our members, those of you that are on the social media platforms. If you're interested, call the church office. Get in contact with us, and we'll connect with you at 713-936-6848. We want to celebrate good relationships. We're building it, okay? If you're part of another church or ministry, we're not trying to steal no members. We just building the kingdom of God. We want to know who you are, so thank you so much for joining us.
So invite somebody, be a blessing to somebody. Invite them a ticket, tell them, come on, and let's fellowship. We need to do more to go to church.
Amen.
Amen. You heard what
I said? Amen.
We need to do more in church. So on Facebook family, we're not going to have Bible study Wednesday, but we will come on there. Wish everybody happy Thanksgiving. And we want to say thank you to our Facebook family. Thank you for following us. Thank you for helping us share the message of faith. We love you. We appreciate you. We will be seeing you guys on next Sunday. God bless you. We'll see you then.